So this is the new MacBook Air. Before I tell you guys all about it, I think it's best to know why I got it. A couple of days ago, out of nowhere, my fairly new 2019 MacBook Pro died. Wouldn't turn on, the screen was black, and it would not charge. Now, this is a big problem for a couple of reasons. Since I'm a sophomore in college right now, most, if not all, of my assignments are done online through this computer. Sure, I could use a phone, but it's really not the same. Also, since I take photos and videos for myself and clients, I was unable to get any creative work done, so I went to go get help. Best Buy couldn't figure out what was wrong, In-N-Out doesn't do computer repairs apparently, and both computer shops I went to said it was broken, and that repairing it would be over $1,000. So with struggling with getting back to class and a $1,000 bill over my head, I did what any broke teenager in this situation would do. Mom! My laptop broke! Just as my new MacBook broke, the new M1 MacBook Air and Pro just released. Interesting timing, Apple. Anyways, after hours of searching for it online, as it was literally sold out at every Apple store within a 100-mile radius of me, finally found one.
What's up, guys? We're in Apple Pasadena in Pasadena, California. We are finally going to pick up my new MacBook Air, but I'll catch you guys in a bit. How's your day today?
It's good, and yours?
Good, good, thank you for asking. This is an exciting moment.
Right?
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Appreciate it, thank you. So we just got the new MacBook Air. So we'll show you guys the rest at home. This is the new 2020 MacBook Air. This is Apple's flagship budget-friendly laptop, but spec'd out with the new M1 chip. Basically, if you don't know what these are or what they mean, in super simple terms, it does everything significantly better and faster. But here's a quick unboxing and look of the 13-inch MacBook Air in silver. Alrighty, unboxing time. You guys hear this ASMR, ready? Whoa. Goodbye. Did you know, a fun fact, Apple makes it really hard to open it, you know, for like that, what's that word? For the suspense, like, whoa. So in the box, we got the MacBook, the USB-C to USB-C charger, which smells really weird. I don't know if you guys smell these, but these always smell really weird. We have like the paper pamphlets with the stickers, and we have the 30-watt charger. So this is the moment we've been waiting for. Ooh, please don't drop it, please don't drop it. ASMR. This is clean. Oh my goodness. So I'll give you guys a really close look. Okay, you guys see that? Now from the sides. And now the back. Are you guys ready? I'll open it with you guys. I don't know if you guys heard that, but basically the keyboard and everything. Hello.
To use English as the main language, press the return key.
Return. Okay, I'm gonna get this set up real quick. Not gonna take super long, but yeah. So I got the base model MacBook Air. For students, it's $899 on Apple right now. The base model comes with 8 gigabytes of memory and 256 SSD.
Yippee!
There's two Thunderbolts on the left and a headphone jack on the right. The design pretty much stays the same every year with minor changes. The MacBook Air doesn't include a touch bar, which I actually don't mind at all. I had it on my last MacBook Pro, and honestly, I really never used it. And when I did, it was kind of annoying to use. I actually miss the physical buttons. So that was a huge factor in me choosing the Air instead of the Pro this year. Anyways, this year was a huge leap in tech advancements for Apple as they integrated the M1 chip in their new lines of MacBooks. The short answer of what I think of this MacBook is that this is literally the best laptop you can get as a student. Value-wise, spec-wise, and honestly, just an overall great laptop. Especially if you're looking to upgrade or get into the Apple ecosystem, this is definitely the year. Here's the example of the huge tech advancements this year. The MacBook Air is pretty much up to this point always Apple's more budget-friendly student version compared to the MacBook Pro. However, this year, the 13-inch 2020 MacBook Air is faster than the 16-inch 2019 MacBook Pro, a laptop that costed $2,400. Now that's crazy. A $900 laptop is faster than Apple's most expensive base model from last year. This means that if you're a student, or a student creative, editing photos, videos, doing graphic design, gaming, anything that requires a little more power than just everyday browsing, this is the MacBook to buy. Usually I buy the MacBook Pro because I do photo and video editing. However, this year the MacBook Air can really hold its own. And honestly, it's not really worth a $300 difference in my opinion. So this will be my daily driver and I'll use it for everything from school to creative work. I love that it's super portable and lightweight for on-the-go work. Anyways, that kind of concludes a short overview of the new 2020 MacBook Air. If you're on the fence and you have the disposable income, I would highly recommend it. If you guys enjoyed and want to see more content like this, subscribe to the channel. Otherwise, have an amazing rest of your day. Bye. Boop.